Hi there. In this video, I will show you how to implement retrieval augmented generation using an MCP server as an alternative to the standard RAC approach. We will build a small agent that lets you chat with Confluence-based product documentation. In my example, the documentation is created and maintained in Confluence here and mirrored for public access with scroll viewport here. The problem with scroll viewport is that it offers very limited agenting capabilities. You can't really have smooth natural language conversation with your documentation. That's why I decided to build this agent. Of course, the same approach works with any documentation stored in Confluence, even if it's not public. Let's go through the implementation steps. First, we need to install the dependencies, the Google ADK and Atlassian's MCP client. The ADK gives us a framework for building the agent, and MCP provides the bridge to Confluence. Next, we import everything we need. The ADK's agent, runner, tool context, plus the MCP toolset. These give us the building blocks to wire up the agent. Then we load the environment variables so the agent can connect to Google's models. I'm using a.environment file here to store my API key, but you can use whatever method works best for you. Now comes the most important part, the read markdown file tool. This tool reads a simple index file written in markdown, which is basically a list of Confluence page summaries, titles, IDs, and links, and stores it in the agent's tool context state. That's why the agent can look up the right page IDs later and retrieve only the relevant page or pages without having to scan all of Confluence. We make sure the file is read only once, then the agent can retrieve it from the tool context. Here, the file is stored in the tool context, and let's take a quick look at how the markdown looks like. It is a simple table with the page summary, page title, page ID, and link, and the page summary is currently too long. It's advisable to shorten the page summaries as this file gets bigger. Going back to the implementation, with that in place, with the tool in place, we define the agent itself. We give it a description here, instructions, and connect two types of tools. Our local read markdown file and the MCP toolset, which provides access to Confluence via get Confluence page here. This setup ensures the agent first consults the index file, then retrieves the right content from Confluence. The instructions guide the agent in its behavior. Agent goal is to provide accurate, concise, and helpful answers based only on the provided Confluence documentation. How it works is, first it analyzes the user's question to determine their specific intent. Then it retrieves the index file if it reads the index file if it is not already stored in the context, and finds the page which is the most semantically close to the user's question. With the retrieved page ID, it calls the get Confluence page tool and gets the information for the content of the page. With having then the content of this page, it generates the final answer and provides it to the user, and it is also instructed to add a link to the documentation so the user can dive deeper into the documentation. And then finally, we create a runner and start the session. Once the agent is up, you can chat with it just like with any other assistant. You ask a question, it looks into the index file, fetches the right page from Confluence, and gives you an accurate answer, always with the link back to the knowledge base. Now let's take a look at how it works. I will start the agent, and like with any new agent, I'm always curious to see which tools it has access to. This isn't a typical user question, but when you're working with an agent connected to an MCP server, it's really useful to know what tools, resources, and prompts are available behind the scenes. Let's ask. Now we will go through the OAuth process because we are connecting to Confluence for the first time. And I will select the knowledge base here and accept. This step is done only once, and then the token is kept alive, so you don't need to authenticate with the MCP every time. And as expected, the agent shows us just the two tools we configured. The local read markdown file for loading the index and the get Confluence page. And that's it, nothing more or nothing less. Let's ask a real documentation related question. For example, tell me about Marmite product, what is it all about? Tell me about Marmite product. What is it all about? So the agent will just first check the index file, find the right page, and then it uses the MCP connection to retrieve the page content from Confluence, and the response it gives is clear and accurate, explaining what Marmite is, what it's used for, and how it helps marketing teams. And it even includes a direct link back to the knowledge base. Let's take a look. We see here the Marmite overview and basics page is being given to us. I will ask another question. Tell me how to install and configure Marmite. And I know there is no documentation page on this topic, so let's see what the agent will reply. It was fast. I'm sorry, but I cannot provide information on how to install and configure Marmite, and so on. But maybe let's ask another question related to the documentation. Which objects are there in Marmite? And see how it will answer. It was quite quick. So in Marmite, objects are the core structural elements used for organizing, planning, and managing marketing activities. And we can see which are the main objects. Those are workspaces, campaign, project, action, and work package. And that's it. We created a small but powerful agent that enables natural language conversations with your Confluence documentation. In my example, in my demo here, it's focused on Marmite's knowledge base, but you can easily adapt it for any Confluence space. This way, you get RAG-like functionality without maintaining your own vector store. The MCP server handles retrieval, and the index file keeps it efficient. You can find this notebook in the GitHub repository shared below this video. Thank you for watching.